Barr's tone and response to the department's gay rights group marked a stark contrast from his predecessor Jeff Sessions, who actively took steps to undermine civil rights protections for gay, lesbian and transgender people. In October 2017, for instance, Sessions sent a memo to federal prosecutors declaring that Title VII of the 1964 Civil Rights Act did not protect workers from gender identity discrimination. In a March letter to Barr, DOJ Pride said the department in recent years has suffered low morale, hurting its ability to retain and recruit new LGBT talent. The group said Sessions had declined ever to issue an EEO statement reiterating the federal government's stance against discrimination, despite requests to do so. Throughout his time at the department, it said, an older EEO statement issued by former Attorney General Loretta Lynch was all that remained up on the department's website. Based on an October 2018 survey, the group found, gay, lesbian and transgender employees felt the workplace environment was no longer the welcoming, inclusive environment it used to be. Of all the respondents in the survey, only 31% said they believed the Justice Department valued LGBT employees. In particular, the survey identified concerns inside both the FBI and BOP, the two largest components of the Justice Department. It also uncovered repeated criticism within the FBI Academy, the agency's law enforcement training and research center, over how gay people are evaluated and treated. An FBI representative said in a statement that the agency is committed to fostering diversity and inclusion in our workforce and it does not tolerate discriminatory behaviors. The BOP, in an emailed statement, said it does not tolerate discrimination and any allegations of misconduct are taken seriously. We are committed to ensuring a safe workplace that is free of discrimination and harassment, the statement said.